this video, we'll go through some best practices for writing a professional email. Whether your email is addressed to your instructor or your fellow peers, it's important to ensure that it's clear, concise, and competent so that your communication will be effective. Before we begin, there are a few important things to keep in mind. When emailing your instructor or peers, use your Forsyth Tech email account rather than a personal email account. This will help to ensure that all communication is kept secure and within the college. When writing an email, it's important to use a courteous tone, proper punctuation, and an appropriate level of formality. You'll want to consider the topic of the email as well as the person to whom it is addressed to when determining these factors. Avoid using slang terms, text lingo, and emoticons within your email, as these are not considered appropriate terms within most professional scenarios. Let's go through an example of what a professionally written email looks like. For this example, we'll be writing an email asking a question addressed to our instructor. We'll start with the subject of our email. In the subject line, you'll want to include two main pieces of information: the prefix, number, and section of your course, as well as a brief description of the email's topic. A good example of this format would be ENG-111-160B, Help Needed with Essay Assignment. As you can see, this example states the appropriate name of the course as well as a short description of the topic that will be discussed in the email. Next, we'll move on to writing the body of our email. We'll start things off with a simple greeting addressed to our instructor. Once we've written our greeting, we'll provide more details regarding the topic of the email, along with specific reference to the assignment being inquired about and concisely addressing our questions. In this case, we would like to ask our instructor a question regarding the Works Cited page of this week's essay assignment, as well as campus resources that can assist us with writing our essay. Lastly, we'll conclude our email with a simple closing along with our name. Before sending your email, a good practice is to proofread all of its contents for grammatical correctness, and to make sure that you have provided all relevant information concerning the topic within it. Once you have finalized your email, you may now send it to your recipient. Congratulations, you have successfully written a professional email.